Hello, welcome back to the game. So, everyone is enjoying themselves. Not me, I have work to do. So, more cutscenes. Oh, this poor zombie fainted here or something, I don't know. So, let's see what Jerry wants. So, ancient shackles. Okay, fine, here is it. Now, let's see this cutscene. What? So far I like the story and it's all making sense right now, so we should be seeing the downfall of the civilization. That's Clotho, by the way, the high priestess. Half of us were taken prisoner, the rest were killed. But who killed them? What? I mean, they are the same villagers revolted against the same village or... Oh... Must take revenge, Bella. What's the point? Look, yeah, they are basically destroyed. Oh, and that's Digus. Nice tree. So this is the swamps. Yeah, Horadric, you traitor. Why did you do it? I left all of this just for love, are you kidding me? Yeah. Horadric will go and save her. And I had to eat the other two. Oh, so I guess they're not immortal in this part of the game, okay. Write the Necronomicon, then we will heal you. Ooh, so again, it makes sense, but we still don't know a lot of things. Oh, about the portal. We looked for the keys and their bearers for 5 years. I think so. I wonder who. So maybe they revolted against the new city. Oh, that could make sense. I mean, they revolted against the city. Oh. Maybe the village was part of the city and they revolted in that part. Okay, I think I got the general story. Yeah, look at this. Get some beer for the four of us. Dead bodies, tortured executions. I wonder who is behind this strong door. You have to cut off my leg or march on. I bet they do. Brother, yeah. He's actually going for it. Well, Kresvold won't stop him. Brother, my brother would have helped me rescue Chain. That's sad in a way. And those heavy footsteps. Oh, hi, birdie, honey. What did they do to you? So she has a bucket of water and other buckets. Ori, is that you? You're free. Ori, we happy? Happy how? Love? Yeah, what right is there to exist? Yeah, they basically destroyed their whole world for love. Not exactly love, I mean the other people wanted to do some other things. So Keeper asked the portal to return him home. So they searched for the case 5 years, they found it. Oh, so the keeper is dead, the others, they're all dead. So when the keepers tried to go home, they died. After all, the man with the red eye found me and took me away. That's all I remember. Who called? So they need ancient trees. Ancient keys that are in Adam's house. The machine says which hill. Try and dig there. Well, that's very interesting. So I guess all the other keepers found all the keys. It took them years and then they died. But this keeper also built this machine. So all the people that came here from Earth are actually some kind of geniuses, or I don't know. Maybe they had special talents when they arrived here. So let's see. Kukal, if you don't know, is the guy who sells you the sword and armor. And he only comes during certain nights. Kukal, where are you? Ah, it's so hard to find the NPCs and they move around in their order. Kukal. So when does he come? So maybe, or maybe he's in, okay. Let's go and search for him. Maybe he's out every night. He's the one that sells weapons from the war camp or whatever it is. So they have stuff. So he should be around here. Oh, there he is, finally. Yeah, so he's out all night. Yeah, I'm your only customer. Then buy something and get out. Get out of what? The forest? It belonged to the first king. He wants help with his hump? Well, that's a mighty big task. Okay, this is getting more funny. But I like they took the story in a direction that I didn't expect. I mean, it's a plot twist, but it's still a little, I don't know, sad and funny at the same time. It's very hard to balance sad and funny in a game. So in a way, I feel sorry for them, but in a way, it's funny how they did it. Because they wanted to be free to work and then they wanted unemployment benefits. And yeah, they killed a lot of people and they... prisoners and stuff. Okay, Witch Hill. So basically, Witch Hill is only this place. Huh. Okay, let's go up to the stand that I never use because... one of the most useless buildings in the game. Yeah. I mean, you stop burning witches, so this was only for one time use. And this was again part of the temple. Clay pot. Of tar. Was that the thing I was supposed to find? Let me see. So that's your main quest. Kukal, where are you? So see, they changed their... order and I don't understand why. Royal services 100%. I keep missing Kukal, where is he? Hello. So that's the farmer, wait, this is silly. Oh, here he was. Okay, let's go to the swamp then. And it's daytime. Hooray for us. Efficiency is our middle name. By the way, this is the house that burned down, so I don't know if you can do anything here. But you also have a grave and a body inside. So this... I don't know who the body belongs to. This is probably the Inquisitor's wife or something. Yeah, just a little bit of trivia, but I would have liked it if you could repair that house and, I don't know, do something there. Now let's hurry to Clotho, because I think she'll ask something of us that will be hard to get or something, I don't know. I handle most of the bodies, so we should have no problem with that anymore. Yeah. I've also been reading more about the game itself on Reddit and some other sources, so this DLC is actually kind of long if you play it from the beginning. Even though you have the tavern, it asks you to do a lot of things and go to a lot of places, so you should interrupt your normal routine.
Tira,
and you're so young, let Clot had a look.
Tira, Tira.
Such a beautiful keeper with a hump, yuck. Oh, okay, so this is again part of the normal game. If you start a new game, you'll not be able to do it, and this is what I mean. Heal potion, I already had that. So if you befriend the Inquisitor, that means you have to advance the story, and the Dark Organs are actually given to you during the story, and you unlock a new perk for that. Well, lucky for us, we have all of that done. Yeah, I also have a collection of dark organs, you know, just in case. Intestines are the hardest one to get, but the brains are pretty easy to get, so let's have a dark brain. Doesn't really say why they are marked by the curse or what's new about them, but maybe you'll find out. Actually, it's still daytime, so we can do some other chores in the meantime. So let's see what our zombies are doing. You are a slacker. More onion. Well, this is going nicely. I mean, you have a lot of things to do. Okay, I guess you'll be on carrot duty, probably. And let's check the other zombies. No, get away! All these points. Okay, let's go and see what else the zombies are up to. So yeah, if you play from the beginning, you probably will have to spend about 20 hours to get to this DLC. Actually, let's go up here, because I wanted to see something. Yeah, this is still marble. So if you're playing the game again, the game will probably be, I don't know, 3 times easier. Well, too bad I can't do anything here. I wish they could move the buffet into our camp, or at least into our tavern, so we can sell burgers there. And maybe instead of witch burning, we could do something like, I don't know, fire jugglers. Okay, let's go to the next objective, because that's how the game is played. You move a lot. I have a bad feeling about this, because you'll use a dark organ and a scroll to change him into something very usual. So maybe that means he's not affected by the curse already. I mean, what's the difference? You have people affected by the curse and people not affected by the curse. Maybe the cursed ones are only the ones that took part in the revolution. I don't know, just a lot of questions. Okay, now let's make fun of his hump. The Gypsy Baron doesn't do anything. I mean, he had a small quest, but it was nothing related to anything. And see, this is a trough for animals. So maybe sooner or later, I don't know, you'll get a horse or something. Especially when they add the city. I suspect they'll add some kind of amount when they add the city, so that you could move between the village and the city with a horse or a carriage or something like that. Or even the donkey. Okay, that would be so funny. Here you go, my friend. Even with my leap, I could have done it faster. Well, I I think I brought a brain. Oh, come on, that's not fair. Now I have to wait again. See, this is why I don't use the teleporter. Home, sweet home. So, yeah, this is not exactly designed to be a standalone DLC. You have to play it during your normal playthrough of the game. Okay, so I saw someone playing this game on stream and they said they say the game is grindy, but yeah, of course it's grindy. The DLC is never a DLC is almost never meant to be played from the beginning of the game. It's something that you unlock while you are progressing through the game. Okay, where's Zen in here? One thing bothers me, why are the stones in this particular order? They should be like a square or something, I don't know, more symmetry. The symmetry is not real here. Okay, once it's nighttime, we should be able to teleport and that will be it. So I have chosen, right, a brain. No, still not dark enough. About now. It's pretty good, it will have to do. So let's go to the starting score. As you can see, our star is up again. Let's see how much money we made. Oh, not so much. We're not really selling enough wine. Nice. I think I should buy some grape seeds because it's not really working out with everything. Well, let me see. I'll actually do that off camera. Because I'm not making enough money, and probably it's because I'm not selling enough wine, I don't know. I also have 13 gold, which is a lot. Take this one. A few days ago, we cut down a crowd of Walking Dead near the pass. Read it or I'll kill you. Boom, boom, boom. Want to look like everyone. Boom, what? But look, now you have a hump, huh? Look over there, a pair of hunchback squirrels. Oh, I know. This spell makes you see everyone like you with humps. Oh, hey. That's not cool. How about some free drinks at my tavern? Well, that sounds better. Oh, now we're talking, yeah. He scares off customers. I'm much more tolerant towards hunchbacks. But I'm not tolerant of bad taverns. Even more? Okay, so now I have to improve my tavern? Well, lucky for us, I have a lot of material stored in the tavern. Well, at least we're getting some upgrades, but still, this Kukul quest is taking so much longer than the others. Okay, let's see, but hey, at least you get to see the full journey. And the journey is what matters, right? Not the outcome. Ooh, I need the silk for this. So how many tables do I have? Four. When will that merchant come? See? I told you I needed to see him. He will come tomorrow or today. Okay, this is kind of bad. I mean, this will make you wait even longer. Oh well, let's see what Horadric is up to. I left the guards patrolling the little village. Yeah, so this was the ancient temple and he turned it into the tavern. Well, that's so cruel. I wonder if they all remember what happened, or if the memories are just available to us, the graveyard keepers. Also, he gave me a dark organ? Why? I needed to hold it? Like, yes, that's okay. Still weird. Why does he have a teleport stone? This could be something. Why did he have a teleporter stone? I mean, is this a bug from the... Hold on, let me check. Was this a bug from the DLC? We'll check right away.
Hello.
Hello, Miss Chain. Oh no, you're Miss Charm actually.
Hello.
I confused. Hey, we're friends. Don't say that. Okay, so let's go home. Yeah, it uses... Okay, I'll keep you as a souvenir. It uses both. It shares the same cooldown. Sadly for us, that's not going to work. So we have to sleep again and wait again. Ah, yes. All that work and now it's just waiting and meditating for a better gameplay. Well, if that's the case, then probably the other artifacts are as hard as to get as this one. But it would have been better if they didn't tie the quest to the tavern. So you should be able to upgrade the tavern as you wish and then do the quest. But yeah, this is like taking the very, very hard road. Also, if I remember correctly, I don't have any extra leather because I didn't order extra leather. Silk or whatever it is, because I finished the church so long ago. Oh well, actually I could check. Maybe have some silk left. That fire is beautiful. By the way, I only light up this fire because it looks nice. Nothing else. Just for show. Yeah, the Halloween update really changed the game. I mean, it looks much better with the horror theme. No, I don't have any silk. Okay, that's nice and all, but still we have a job to do. Carrots, I have plenty of carrots left. Okay, let's give a command to our little zombies to make wine and then we'll be off. Finally some wine. I need more water. Well, why are you not working? Is it full or something? Okay, we need to check that as well then. No, everything is empty. Oh, I don't know what's happening. Then it's probably the zombie just ran out of materials. Poor zombie, he wants to work with all his passion and all his love, but he doesn't have enough materials. Yeah, it appears you have to keep an eye out on your production because you'll run out of it soon. Here's a weird music. So now I have the 8 silk that I need, and that's the maximum you can get, as you can see. Oh, I forgot to check how much we need for the other tables. Okay, it's math time. If I remember correctly, I needed 4 planks and 4 of the other things. Yeah. 8 planks and 4 for one, so... that's a pretty amount of things I need. Okay, let's go back and do it. Usually I don't do cuts in games like this because that will make me unable to play the episode and then I'll forget about it. So I try to play a few episodes when I have the time and then publish them at once. I don't really do YouTube like other people do because I saw some people, I mean, they record 5 episodes and then they release them in about 5 to 10 days. But that's a bit silly to me, because it's not about the views, it's just finishing a good game. And yeah, after playing so many games, I really want to finish some good games, because... to be honest, this year has been the worst year in gaming. Not a lot of good games, not a lot of... I don't know, a lot of good ideas. Ah, fine, use the lower quality ones, whatever. So So let me see, four, I need four of these. Yeah, that will do. Take a break, zombie. I'll handle it from here. Actually, I think I have them crafted already, but I guess some extra doesn't hurt. An 832. Here you go. Okay, let's put the dark brains in here. I'll not forget about them, I'm sure of that. That was not enough. Not nearly enough. So this should do it. Again, sorry zombie. You're still on break. And you can watch the beautiful saw animation. See? It slows down and it picks right up. When you finish the task. The attention to details in a game like this is what it's exactly what makes it so fun. Like this windmill over here actually uses a pump to get the water out of the well and into this reservoir. So that should be enough. Let's go back to the tavern, build the tables. Actually, I think I need to demolish the tables first. Yeah, people. I'll destroy all your tables. You'll also get some extra materials from them. Let's see what happens to the person. Yeah. It just sits there looking weird. I don't know, why did they make me upgrade the tavern if they're just going to make me demolish it? Oh, now it looks a lot better. Oh man, that cuckoo is crazy, but he has good tastes in furniture. 10, that's good. Tavern quality is going very, very high right now. Yeah, we should be getting a lot more money. Tavern upgrade bonus, 88. I'm enjoying this new look, especially at the rat races. Sadly, you can't do anything at the rat races, you just look at them. So what did that do? I mean, they have tablecloths and nicer chairs. Oh well, I guess that will do. Zombie, are you working? Yes. And another thing, we still have no idea where this bridge leads to. Because this is clearly a bridge and it might have led to the lighthouse, but I doubt it. Maybe it was on some island or on some port or something. Remember, everything was destroyed, so you're basically on an island for all we know. I guess you have a road here. This is the road to the mountain fort. It's not exactly an island, but the rest of the map seems to be covered, so down is the city. Up is the mountain fort. So we might be looking at two DLC coming soon. Or one DLC with the mountain fort and one with the city. Well, it's already dark, so Kukul should be here. Hello, my hunchback friend. Is that enough? Oh, finally, and it's only the pickaxe head. Oh, these people, it's so hard to please them. Even though we're living in a world that is cursed by an ancient god and we still have no idea what's really going on, they still are so picky about all their things. So hooray, another cutscene incoming. I should be able to finish the game in, I think, 3 episodes if nothing else comes up. Nice zombie. So what's the correct order? No idea, yes, of course you know, I'm so tired. I'm so tired, that's exactly what I think. Years later after the incident. See, this is exactly what I meant. The bridge led to somewhere, to the plane of the dead, because the bodies are floating through there, and that's an energy bridge. We have fought for many long years and... the pagans and their ancient god are no more. What? I King Jove, thank you all, you're free. You must destroy the ancient bridge, but why? It's to the land of the dead. To the sky realm of the new god. Oh, that's so bad. Bloody quitters. Don't do it, that's the land of the dead. Oh, that's the ancient pickaxe used by Lucius. Hey. That's sad, actually. That was a mistake, that was a big mistake. Achievement unlocked, Viva la King. No, they're not cool, they destroy the entire... they destroy almost the entire... I don't know, this world or whatever it is. Also, let's put this here. Ah, that's better. Also, where is the next NPC? Maybe I can do it in this video. I don't remember what I have to do. Can Jerry refresh my memory, maybe? Okay, this is kind of bad. So where are the ancient keys? Oh, it's Adam. Okay, so let's see if we can do it. Actually, this is for the